Përshëndetje miq, mirë se vini në programin Familia 7. Izraeli në rrjedhën e ngjarjeve historike ka pasur situata të ndryshme që e kanë lidhur me Shqipërinë. Kështu gjatë fundit të luftës së dytë botërore, familjet shqiptare mirëpritën një numër të madh familjesh hebreje, duke treguar për kujdesjen dhe solidaritetin e tyre në këtë situatë. Por nuk mbeti vetëm de facto. Në 19 gusht të vitit 1991, Izraeli dhe Shqipëria vendosen zyrtarisht marrëdhënie diplomatike mes tyre. Gjatë këtyre viteve marrëdhënie dhe kjo miqësia ka ardhur është përforcuar më tepër. Jemi sonte me ftuarin ton ambasadorin e Izraelit në Shqipëri, zoti Noa Galgatler. Zoti Galgatler, faleminderit që jeni këtu me ne sonte dhe pranuat të ftesën për këtë intervistë.
It's my pleasure.
Do doja të dija çfarë mendoni se e bën bashk sot Shqipërinë edhe Izraelin.
Basically, it's a story of our shared history and the fact that you protected the Jews so beautifully during the Second World War and even before and after. Mm-hmm. So we are grateful to you. And this is the fundamental pillars of our relations, of course. And as of today, your government is very friendly to our government. And of course, mm-hmm. it serves us very well when it comes to relations.
E keni quajtur Shqipëri një pishtar tolerance. Mendon se kjo duhet të ndiqet nga të gjithë?
It's a must. I mean, this story should be told everywhere. We did our share this year when we translated an educational curriculum in Israel mm-hmm. about the salvation of the Jews of Albania to the Albanian language in order to introduce it for high school students here in Albania. Because this story is, when I talk to Albanians, it seems very obvious to Albanians, but it's not so obvious around the world. Mm-hmm. So we should tell it together to everybody.
Shqipëria dhe Izraeli kanë marrëdhënie të mira, referuar edhe ngjarjeve historike. Shumë vite më parë shqiptarët kanë mirëpritur hebrejt, kanë hapur dyert e tyre për ta. Cila është konsiderata juaj për shqiptarët?
The fact that I'm here, I asked to come to be ambassador to this country is because of a great appreciation that they feel to the Albanian people. We talked about it 2 minutes ago, and now it's our task to use this beautiful history in order to promote our relations, mm-hmm. Not only political diplomatic relations, but also commercial, academic, things that related to culture and sciences and everything that is of importance for both countries.
A mendoni ju se është bërë sa duhet në ndërgjegjësimin e shqiptarëve, por edhe të komunitetit izraelit në Shqipëri për Holokaustin? Çfarë mendimi keni ju për këtë?
I think that in Israel we did our share so far, and I believe that about 70% of the students, in high school students in Israel, they studied the story of the Albanian salvation of the Jews. Of course, we can do much more, and we try to do it. As I said some minutes ago, the translation of the curriculum to the Albanian language. And we assist the Albanian authorities also in other parts of the world, telling this story in Washington, in New York, and in Europe as well. But of course, because very soon we will not have any survivors of the Holocaust to testify, we should do a lot of efforts in order to have this story told.
Zoti Galgatler, ne si staf, si televizion, jemi lutur për Izraelin. Jemi lutur që të mos ketë humbje në jetë njerëzore për shkak të konflikteve Izrael-Palestinë. Çfarë dëshironi? Cila është dëshira juaj për popullin e Izraelit?
Of course, we would like very much to achieve peace. Now, this is a very good time to talk about it because only in the last year we achieved peace and diplomatic relations with 4 Arab countries. Mm-hmm. Morocco, Bahrain, Sudan, and the United Arab Emirates. It shows us that peace is achievable. Mm-hmm. And we have peace with Egypt and Jordan for many years. We pray for it. Now, Hamas in the Gaza is not a very good example because it's a terrorist organization that opposes the right of Israel to exist. We cannot negotiate with terrorist organization, but we have nothing against Palestinians. And I believe that in the future, mm-hmm. we'll have peace with the Palestinians as well, and with many other countries in the Arab world. Mm-hmm.
Unë do doja që të ndalesha tek një pjesë tjetër, në fakt të flisnim pak për punën tuaj si ambasadë në vendin tonë në Shqipëri. Ju keni dhënë një kontribut shumë të madh, por do doja të na tregosh pak më shumë për kontributin tuaj si ambasadë, kryesisht në periudhën e pandemisë.
We try to share our knowledge and know-how. Of course, we are very much limited because, for example, we cannot share our vaccination that we have in Israel, the stocks that we have, because it's a matter of contract between the supplying companies and ourselves. But we try to do it, and if we get the permission, of course, we'll try to support as well with vaccination. But except of vaccination, we share our know-how. And because of the fact that Israel is so successful in combating COVID, this experience that we have is very fruitful for many other countries. How to handle the pandemic and how to come back to life, to normal life, which is the case of Israel today.
Dhe një pyetje të fundit, si e shikoni ju ecurinë e Shqipërisë si një vend demokratik? Çfarë uroni ju për Shqipërinë, për popullin shqiptar?
First of all, I'm very much impressed because I visited this country about 12 years ago while I was ambassador to Bulgaria, and I see the difference. It's very clear. Democracy is very vivid here. Only some weeks ago, you had the general elections and everything went very smoothly, like in my country, by the way. And for us, it's important to strengthen the bilateral relations in all aspects. But I believe that the moment the pandemic is over, we will put a lot of attention on economic relations and on certain topics like agriculture, tourism and scientific cooperation.
Unë dua të të falenderoj, falenderit për ato që na solle sonte dhe të uroj shumë sukses në punën tënde.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Mos u largoni, ne rikthehemi pas pak në programin Familja 7 me të tjerë të ftuar.